Ok, Belén, Cami, vamos a entrar a ver el verbo to be. Ya lo habíamos visto en la clase anterior en forma presente simple. Y vamos a verlo en la forma de pasado. El verbo to be. Ok. Una de las diferencias en el verbo to be en pasado es que se subdivide solo en dos: was and were. ¿Ok? So, cuando hablamos del verbo to be en pasado, so nos vamos a referir solo en dos, que son was, singular, were, plural. No es como en el presente. En el presente el to be se subdivide en tres: am, is, and are. En el pasado solo en dos, ¿ok? Was, singular, were, plural. Was, singular, ejemplo, men, one, was, were, plural. Men. So vamos a ver cómo se, con qué perdón, con qué sujetos se subdividen.
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning, Christian. Ok, so vamos a ver el verbo to be, cómo se deriva, con cuáles, perdón, con cuáles sujetos se deriva. El was, como es singular, va a ir con el sujeto I, he, she, and it. I was, he was, she was, it was. Y el plural va a ir siempre con el we were, you were, they were. ¿Ok? So ya sabemos entonces que el verbo to be en pasado simple se deriva en dos, was and were. Y los sujetos que van con cada uno de ellos es I, he, it, con was, singular. We, you, and they, con were, plural. Se repito, estamos viendo el verbo to be en pasado simple. En pasado es diferente porque el verbo to be solo se deriva en dos, was, singular, and were, plural. No es como en el presente, se deriva de tres: am, is, are. En el pasado solo van was and were. Y los sujetos que acompañan a cada uno son I, he, she, it. En singular y we, you, they. En plural. So hasta ahí estamos bien. Okay. ¿Alguna pregunta, alguna duda antes de continuar? Cami, Christian, Katy. Belén, ¿todo bien?
Sí.
Katy, okay, good. So tenemos 10 enunciados, 10 oraciones, 5 en el izquierdo, 5 en la derecha. De lo que acabamos de ver, lo vamos a poner en inglés. Dice, él estuvo muy enfermo, eso fue genial, yo fui muy tímido, estuve en mi casa todo el día, ella estaba muy deprimida. Los niños estaban en el parque. Estuvo muy ocupado, fuimos muy buenos amigos, ellos estuvieron en la oficina, mis papás eran muy estrictos. Vamos a ponerlas en inglés. Recuerden que estamos con el to be, pero en pasado simple. Ok. ¿Listos o todavía necesitan un poquito más de tiempo? Katy.
Un poquito más, teacher.
Ya, okay. Okay. Cristian, ¿cómo va?
Terminando, profe.
Okay. Cami.
Igual, teacher.
Casi. Okay. Vamos, few more minutes, unos minutos más. Está bien. Okay, vamos a ver cómo lo tenemos. Comencemos. Katy, le escucho. Dígame.
Ay, a ver, él estuvo muy enfermo. He was very sick.
Okay, continúe. Ya al rato chequeamos. No, Katy tiene que hacerme todas.
Okay.
All right.
Eso fue genial. It was weird.
¿Ah?
Eso fue genial. It
Ajá.
was weird.
Okay.
Yo fui muy tímido. I was very shy.
Shy, se pronuncia.
Shy.
Yes. Ya lo chequeamos. Vamos.
I was at my house all day. He was very depressed.
Okay,
The
sigamos.
children were in the park. You were very busy, busy.
Busy.
Busy. A ver, you were very busy. We were very good friends. They were in the office. My parents were very strict.
Okay, Katy, thank you. Ya vamos a chequear. Cami.
He was very sick. It was great. I was very shy. I was in my house every day. She was very depressed. The children were in the park. You were very busy. We were very good friends. They were in the office. My parents were very strict.
Okay, Cami, thank you. Ya chequeamos. Christian.
Yes,
Go ahead.
he was very sick. It was great. I was very shy. I was at my home all day. She was very
Depressed.
depressed. They were in the park. You were very busy. We were very good friends. They were in the office. In the office, they were very strict.
Okay. Ya vamos a ver. Belén.
Disculpe, profe, lo que pasa es que se me fue el internet
No,
y
no, ya.
no pude
Supuse.
copiar.
Ok, no hay problema, Belén. So,
Ajá.
ya, vamos a ver. En los próximos continúa. Ok.
Sí.
That's ok. It's ok. Nos pasa. Ok, so vamos a revisar. Like this. All right. On the left side, he was very sick. It was great. It was very shy. I was at home all day. He was very depressed. The kids were in the park. You were very busy. We were very good friends. They were in the office, and my parents were very strict. Si tienen que corregir, corrijan algo. Ok. Lo importante de aquí es su estructura. Sujeto, verbo to be en pasado y el complemento. Sujeto, verbo to be en pasado y el complemento. Es la estructura que se maneja con el verbo to be en pasado simple. Y ustedes lo hicieron muy bien. So recuerden la estructura. Sujeto, verbo to be, en pasado y el complemento. All right, so aquí tenemos las tres formas en que nos expresamos con el verbo to be en pasado simple: afirmativo, negación y pregunta. Afirmativo, negación y pregunta. ¿Ok? So, ¿cuál tenemos la estructura? Ya acabamos de ver la primera, que era afirmación. Sujeto, verbo to be en pasado y el complemento. Repito, sujeto. Verbo to be en pasado y el complemento en afirmación. En negación, igualmente, sujeto, el verbo to be más la negación, en este caso es wasn't o was not, y el complemento. Y en pregunta, siempre el verbo to be, en este caso estamos viendo el pasado, el verbo to be en pasado siempre va a ir primero. Luego el sujeto y después el complemento. Son las tres formas en que nos expresamos: afirmativo, negación y pregunta. En este caso estamos viendo el verbo to be. Okay. So ya tenemos las tres estructuras. Vamos a leerlo. The exam, afirmativo. The exam was very difficult. You were in the party. My brother was very shy. They were on holiday. Negación. The exam wasn't very difficult. You weren't in the party. My brother wasn't very shy. They weren't on holiday. Question: Was the exam very difficult? Were you in the party? Was my brother very shy? Were they on holiday? Vamos a ver. Katy, pronunciemos por favor las tres formas.
A ver, the exam was very difficult. You were in the party. My brother was very shy. They were on holiday. Was the exam very difficult? Were you in the party? Was my brother very shy? Very shy. Were they on holiday? The
Okay.
exam wasn't very difficult. You weren't in the party. Your brother wasn't very shy. They were They were on holiday.
Okay. Cami.
The exam was very difficult. You were in the party. My brother was very shy. They were in holiday. Was the exam very difficult? Were you in the party? Was my brother very shy? Were they on holiday?
Siga.
The exam wasn't very difficult. You weren't in the party. My brother wasn't very shy. They weren't on holiday.
Okay. Belén.
The exam was very difficult. You were in the park. My brother was very shy. They were on holiday. Was the exam very difficult? Were you in the park? Was my brother very shy? Were they on holiday? The exam wasn't very difficult. You weren't in the park. My brother wasn't very shy. They weren't on holiday.
Okay. All right. Christian?
The exam was very difficult. You were in the party. My brother was very shy. They were on holiday. Was the exam very difficult? Were you in the party? Was my brother very shy? Were they on holiday? The exam wasn't very difficult. You weren't in the party. My brother wasn't very shy. They weren't on holiday.
Okay. Adverbs. All right. Muy bien. So ya tenemos las tres formas en que nos expresamos con el verbo to be en pasado. Simple. Afirmativo, negación y pregunta. Okay, su estructura. Ahora vamos a poner en práctica. Tenemos 10 enunciados. Vamos a usar el verbo to be en pasado correctamente en los que están en blanco. Va el verbo to be. Vamos a ver cómo lo hacemos. The weather, blank, very nice yesterday. Michael Jackson, blank, very famous singer. We, blank, in Paris last year. When, blank, your last birthday. Alice, blank, my first girlfriend. My friends, blank, very happy. I, blank, at home yesterday. Alice and I, blank, very good friends. It, blank, very late. He, blank, very smart. So vamos a poner el correcto verbo to be en los espacios. Vamos a practicar. Okay. Let's work. Vamos a trabajar. Okay. Belén?
Oh, no, profe.
No, okay. No. Christian?
Yes.
¿Acabó? ¿Lo tiene?
Sí.
All right, le escucho.
The weather was very nice yesterday. Michael Jackson was a very famous singer. We were in Paris last year. When were your last birthday? Alice